Good morning, this is Pastor Gabriel Varga, pastor of the Daytona Rescue Mission in the Ridgewood Avenue Baptist Church. It's July the 25th, and we're doing our daily Bible reading to get through the Bible in a year. I hope you do it and you join us in this endeavor. 80 hours to read the Bible through, that is only 14 minutes a day for the average reader. The reading for today is Psalms 44, 45, and 46 in the Old Testament, and the New Testament reading is in the book of Acts, chapter 25. So we're going to look at the 46th Psalm today, and it'll be a blessing, I think, and I encourage you to read all of these to get through the Bible in a year, but let's comment on this now. It says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Trouble comes, you know, if you're in trouble right now, which many of us are. Probably you got 2, 3, 4 different troubles right now, or you're just got out of a trouble. You might get into 2 more. If you're trouble free right now, you probably have trouble tomorrow. So there is trouble, and I'm glad another portion of Scripture tells us that the Lord will deliver us from all of our trouble. Oh, isn't that a wonderful thing? And here it says that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. So something that is he's right there with you. We have his presence. We have his countenance. We know he's here. We have strength in him, and he's a refuge for us. It says, therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah, there is a river which streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen rage, and the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, and the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us, and the God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He makes wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow, and cutteth the spears in sunder. He burneth the chariots in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Oh, what a wonderful thing it is that we have this refuge, that we have this strength. When it tells of the mighty hand of God that, of course, wins in war, you know, it told us in the Psalms just preceding this that it's not the bow that wins the war. It's not the matter of our armament, but it's a matter of the strength of God. And, of course, we certainly see this very clearly in the Old Testament with the battles that the children of God had, the children of Israel, and the mighty battles that Saul had won, and then, of course, David and others after them. The hand of God, when they obeyed God and they were in God's will, they had victory. Oh, they could defeat the giants. They could defeat the Amalekites. There was nothing that could stop them when they were pleasing to God. Now, let's just say this today. If you and I please God, we don't have the battles they had. We don't. It was a little different in the Old Testament, and God's people, the Israelites, the Jewish people, they were a nation, and they had wars. When they were obedient to God, they won the wars. When they were disobedient to the Lord, they got defeated, and that's the way things were. And, you know, of course, and when you had a mighty man like David, he came, and they sang the song, Saul had killed his thousands, and David his tens thousands. So David was a man after God's own heart. So as the leader, he had much more power of God in his life, and he did very well. But you know, there was a time, isn't it sad, in David's life when he was supposed to be out there battling. It said when the kings went to war, what did David do? He hung around back home. Now that wasn't a very good thing that he stayed home. And he got in trouble. He looked where he shouldn't have looked, and he saw the beautiful Bathsheba, and he lusted for her and brought her unto himself and committed adultery with her and conceived a child and he murdered Uriah, Bathsheba's husband, and he did terrible things because he wasn't doing what he's supposed to. He had great victories, and yet then when the kings went to war, he didn't, and he stayed back and got in trouble. You and I can get in trouble. The Lord can be a strength for us, and he can be a redeemer for us, and he can take us out of these difficulties and these problems. And so it's very clear here of what God can do in regards to these things. And like it said in verse 9, he maketh wars to cease in the ends of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in fire. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. You know, sometimes we need to just be careful. Be quiet. Be quiet and just let God be God. Just meditate upon the scriptures and see what God is doing. And we will see that this would be a wonderful way to do things. Oh, there's a God in heaven that can be our strength and refuge in the time of trouble. The Lord of hosts was with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. And that's the way this psalm finishes in verse number 11. And this is a wonderful psalm. We see the psalmist, he gives us strength. The psalms, all of the psalms, as we're reading through them through the Bible in the year, it gives us hope, and it tells us of God, and it tells us what God hath done and what he will do. This is a very, very important thing of what God can do and what he will do. So, dear one, let us be studying these psalms as we're going ahead day by day, and the New Testament reading, Acts 25 today, and we will see that this will be a blessed thing to us. And so, dear one, I hope that that you are continuing to read, and I hope especially today this little message of God will be our refuge and our strength, and he will win the battles, and he delivers us out of all of our troubles, and you can have that even today. Please read the rest of your scriptures for today, the 44th, the 45th, and 46th Psalm, and Acts chapter 25. God bless you. I hope you're finishing reading through the Bible in a year. We'll see you tomorrow.